Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to another episode of High School Romance Magi Trials. When we last left off, we basically just did some practicing with Ari and Charlie doing some magic practices, and we levitated and a couple of other things, and then we went to try out our abilities against me and Charlie, and then I accidentally hurt Charlie. So yeah, and we're in a bad situation right now, and we have to make a choice, so let's get back to the story. Choices. What was the previous line? Are you going to stay in here and mope, or are you going to do something about it? Like what? Like go to her. I'm not supposed to. But when has that ever stopped me before? Even if I did, what could I do for her? I'm the reason she's in there in the first place. I'm not the best person you could go for sentimental advice, but even I know an apology in person goes a long way. It's like looking at boobs. A picture is great and all, but there's just something special about seeing them in person. Okay. You're right. Okay. I know, I'm a boob expert. Not about that. About the apology. About the fact that I shouldn't just be sitting here chewing my nails off. I need to see her. I think she likes you, you know. My feet froze on the spot. What? I'm a demon, not Cupid. I could be wrong, but when does that ever happen? Just, it's a feeling I get. She doesn't like me.
So?
So, it's because she thinks I'm competition.
Now that Ari puts the idea in my brain, I can't shake it. I have to make sure she's okay. I have to see it for myself. Aren't you tagging along too?
I think I'll sit this one out. I'll just be enjoying the comforts of your bed. Close the door on your way out.
It's not like anyone could see her. But I close the door anyway, heading through the dark and silent school. I slip inside quietly. The room is mostly empty, except the small silhouette of Charlie beneath the covers. I can hear her breathing soft and regular. Maybe she's still unconscious. There's no one with her, that could be a good sign. Maybe she's expected to be fine. Begging that none of the healers come in, I crept toward Charlie's bed. The sense of purpose I had found vanishes again, seeing her still face. Not peaceful, just absent. But then, slowly, it starts to shift. My breath catches in my throat as she grimaces, squinting up at me.
Sophie?
Hey! She closes her eyes again, grimacing against the attempt at talking. Maybe I should get help. Hold on.
Wait.
She grabs my wrist before I can leave, pulling me close.
Don't think I don't know you're not supposed to be here.
She smiles.
Places where you're not supposed to go are always your favorite. Are you okay?
She reaches a hand up, her fingertips gliding against my cheek. Me? I'm the one who should be asking you that. She starts to shake her head, but grimaces.
No, the whole time, what little I could actually think, I just thought, what if this is how I left you? I wasn't afraid of dying, I was just afraid that you'd blame yourself. All that guilt. It wasn't your fault, but I know that wouldn't have mattered. But I didn't die, so I guess there's no sense in worrying about it.
I swallow thickly.
Don't look so glum, Sophie. I'm still around to torture you.
I'm just gonna go ahead and say, you don't torture me.
Maybe I just need to try harder then?
No, that's not. That isn't what I meant.
I think I know what you meant.
Her fingers brush along my knuckles slowly.
Is that my blood under your nails?
My hand twitches in her grip at the realization, but she holds to it fast, her gaze shifting.
Stay. It's all right. I guess my thick skull finally paid off.
I scoff quietly under my breath. I can't stop thinking about what you said, about the sorcerer trials and how I'm just throwing it all away for half a chance. I don't want to put you through what I almost went through.
But you have to.
What?
Don't you think I figured it out? It's just who you are, isn't it?
You don't know anything about who I am. Her expression falls a bit, and I realize it probably sounded a lot harsher than I meant. I mean, you do, it's just, I haven't been entirely honest with you. The truth sits stuck in my tongue.
Come on, I could be bleeding into my brain or something here. You better tell me fast.
Okay, now you're just trying to make me feel bad. She grins guiltily. Charlie, my name isn't Sophie.
What?
I desperately want to pull my hand back from hers, afraid of how she'll react. But I have to tell her. She deserves to know the truth. It's Sean. The first wave of confusion fills her face. I'm not the best at decision-making under stressful circumstances.
I've caught on, yeah.
Before I was supposed to face Magi Shira in my trial, I used a spell I shouldn't have used, and it turned me into this. Into a girl. Her expression stays unreadable, looking over me slowly.
So you're telling me that you found a spell that made you go from flat-chested to a D-cup and you didn't share?
What? Oh, right. Why am I even telling you this now? You have a head injury.
Hey, I'm not an invalid. Look, I have to admit, I didn't see this coming. Like, you're not really the greatest at pretending you're a girl, but I thought you were just, you know, you. Not that it makes much of a difference.
Then you're just okay with it? With everything?
Okay might be a strong word. I would have liked some warning before I let you get a sneak peek at the goods.
Now you're just starting to sound like Aerie.
Heaven forbid.
She looks at our clasped hands again, sighing softly.
If you're Sean, then fine. You're Sean, I guess.
I shrug. No, it's... I like being Sophie for you. You're friends with her.
I'm friends with you. Whatever your name or your gender is, that doesn't really make a difference. Just try not to lie to me next time.
Next time? If I ever accidentally turn myself into a cat, I'll be sure to let you know immediately. She grins at me, and it makes my heart swell a little bit. I didn't think she'd be this understanding. I don't think I would have been this understanding. But Charlie is something else.
Hey.
She nudges my arm gently.
You have a trial to pass, and just in case I'm bleeding into my brain, and for luck...
What? Where did this come from? The feeling of her lips tingle against mine, softer than I expected of someone who could speak so bluntly. She must have really hit her head. Her hands hold me in place, but I don't struggle. Charlie.
Don't ruin it. Whatever you're about to say, just don't. It doesn't have to mean anything. You don't have to feel anything at all, okay? I just wanted to do it, just once. Maybe twice.
Okay. This is clearly supposed to be the announcer. It's supposed to be Sophie talking to herself, not Charlie, so I'm not gonna read it like this. Her lips met mine again, and this time I responded in kind. I'm a man of many vices, okay? It's a perfectly reasonable reaction when a girl is practically throwing herself at you. And it is Charlie. Much as I've been focused on my own troubles and drama, she's been with me through it all, in her own way. She pulls back finally.
There, now go get some sleep.
But...
Sleep!
Her voice chases me out of the room, my thoughts still spinning as I go. Well, how did it go? Bizarrely, she kissed me. Her eyes light up, like I just connected a wire in her brain. Really? Did you two do it in the hospital bed? No. One step at a time, I suppose. So she kissed a girl. And I...
Ah.
Okay. Sorry. Sorry, I just had a brain aneurysm. I'm back. And I liked it. I told her the truth.
And she still kissed you?
She did. I sit down on the bed slowly, still taking in what happened.
She must be into some interesting kinks.
Alright, I don't know why I thought I could talk to you about this. I'm going to sleep. Why don't you go stay with Charlie?
I don't have the best bedside manner. I'll just go spy on who's cheating on who tonight. The gossip never stops, you know.
Oh, did Magic Shira come by tonight?
No, she never did.
I wonder if my incident with Charlie just furthered Mage Warren's case against me. I don't know. I lay down to sleep on my own, my thoughts about that kiss still spinning. Huh. Ooh, God, excuse me. Doing Aerie's voice brings out all the gas in my stomach. Now that ugly description's over.
Sophie?
How is she? I bounce to my feet before I'm even awake, Magi Shira sighing and taking me by the shoulder to balance me.
Charlie's recovering fine. We have a few last days to finish lessons, and then...
I nod. I'm ready. We run through the same drills again, the ones we've been perfecting for weeks. But it feels so basic. I'm terrified it won't be enough. For the next 3 days, I try to focus on training. But my thoughts keep wandering back to Charlie. I didn't know they would keep her for so long. Despite being someone who regularly makes it a sport of driving me crazy, Harry might be the only thing that keeps me sane. At least she's company, a distraction from all the thoughts swirling around my head. Failure, worry, guilt. I end up training alone after our usual classroom hours, missing Charlie's help. 2 days. Only 2 days left, and then...
It's just a single fight, though, isn't it? It doesn't really mean anything.
It means everything. It means it's my only second chance into getting this into this academy as an official student and not some charity case. Charity chase is what that said, but I assumed it meant case.
It's not like the academy is that great.
Getting into the academy is everything. Without that, I'm nothing.
Don't put it like that. You're still hot, that means something. And if it doesn't go well, then you could say forget the magic and I'll show you how to sleep your way to the top.
Thanks, Aerie. No problem. I think that's what Aerie meant to say. I'm not trying to rant, guys, but god damn it. This is just getting worse. So I'll re-say it.
No problem.
I have to forcibly remind myself that she's trying to help.
Are you ready, Sophie?
I nearly jump out of my skin. Hopefully she didn't hear me talking to myself. I nod and strip down for the ritual, my face burning under the scrutiny of Aerie's interested gaze.
Oh, what's this?
I try my best to ignore her as the demon pulls stealthily at the side of my bra.
You look unusually warm, Sophie. Are you certain you're all right?
Her hand goes to my forehead, eyes scrutinizing. I'm fine.
If you say so, I don't want you falling ill before your trial. It wouldn't be fair.
She begins the ritual as usual, pouring relaxation throughout my veins like a cool water. Aerie's forehead creases slightly as she stares at me. I wonder if she's jealous. I sent her away all those nights when she could have been getting this free show. My mind drifts along with my body, hearing my own pulse thrumming in my veins. I sigh as her hand reaches my thighs, sliding along the side of my leg and traces a finger down the slope of my knees. By the time she repeats the motion, I'm already asleep. Huh.
Psst! Hey! Wake up, damn it!
What? What time is it?
It's wake the hell up o'clock! Do you have any idea what just happened?
You ruined my sleep? Ow, what was that for?
For waking you up.
Well, congrats, you succeeded. I rub my cheek irritably, glaring at Aerie with a scowl that physically hurts my face. What do you want?
I want to look out for you. What Magi Shira just did, why did she do it?
It's just a ritual to balance magic energy, which is naturally chaotic or something? I don't remember. We started doing this ages ago, but it has a purpose.
Yeah, the purpose being to squeeze all the magic out of you like you're a ripe orange for her dark magic OJ.
What?
What she's doing isn't balancing your energy or whatever new age crap you're rambling about. She's putting you to sleep because she's rapidly draining your magic. Trust me, I know what that looks like, and her magic levels went through the roof. Your aura is barely visible right now.
But, no, that can't be right. Magi Shira has been helping us this whole time.
I know what I saw, Sophie. Why do you think you always feel so tired afterward? If it was supposed to make you more powerful, wouldn't you feel more powerful too?
But Magi Shira, she...
is really, really bad news. This is a pretty common technique for dark mages, and definitely forbidden. Demons do it all the time, predator and prey. Like, it's kinda hot coming from a human, but I guess you're kinda cool and I don't want anything to happen from you. Or happen to you.
Charlie. I try to lurch forward suddenly. She could be up there doing it to Charlie. A warm hand grabs my shoulder and pushes me back.
Even if she is, that's fine. Charlie doesn't need her magic right now anyway, right? She's all cuddled up in medical. It's not like Shira's going to kill either of you. She needs you alive. She's going to make you her personal magic milking cows.
Do you have to put it like that?
There was a lot of touching in inappropriate places. I call it like I see it.
Still, I need to help her. Or I need to tell her. Sorry. I blink toward the doorway, willing my body to move, but it's like my limbs are cemented to the bed.
As if you're going to get anywhere after that. You have to sleep and recover your magic. But I can be your massage girl, I guess. I do like seeing the medical magi in all those short robes.
Alright. It feels like I'm dreaming as Aerie leaves. Magi Shira was taking magic from me this whole time? She seems so intent on helping me, on seeing me achieve my dream. And her own. Didn't she mention something about that when we first met? She said we were similar somehow, ambitious. My fingers curl slowly into the covers. I am ambitious, I'll freely admit to that, but I'm not ruthless, I'm not a monster. Shira's ritual is still taking the life out of me, though. Even if the school was burning down, I'd barely have enough energy to get myself outside. I guess I can trust Aerie to tell Charlie. The light starts to fade again. My eyelids slide shut. Shira. Next morning, I get ready in a hurry, throwing my robe on. What am I going to do? I have to see Charlie. First thing, before class. I have to... Charlie! I grab onto her elbow before she can fall. Where did you come from?
Medical?
Sorry, I didn't see you. Don't tell me you, Don't let me give you another head injury.
I might seriously kill you if you manage to pull that off.
She looks into my face, eyes swimming with just as much silent urgency as my own. She glances around furtively before she starts to whisper.
Harry told me last night.
You're starting to learn about her tricks. I feel like I summoned you just by thinking about you. Where is she?
Watching Magi Shira to make sure she doesn't do anything else suspicious.
I wish we'd let her see this before.
What are we supposed to do?
I've been thinking about this all morning, turning the possibilities over in my mind. Boy, that is a lot of situations. Oh boy. Okay, so... I don't know, guys. This feels like a really tough situation. Like, this is... If you have three choices in a visual novel, it usually means shit's about to go down, and one of these choices is life or death. Like, if you choose the wrong one, you failed the route, you gotta restart over again. Alright. So let's see here. Let's think about this calmly and rationally. So, let's go from the bottom. There's nothing we can do. That sounds like a no-brainer. That's obviously the wrong choice to choose. There's clearly plenty we can do. We can confront Shira or tell somebody. I mean, we can get Mage Master Armon or Mage Warren. Like, we have plenty of options. Nothing we can do. Nixed. Next, tell someone. Okay, so we could tell someone, like I just said, Mage Warren or Master Mage Armon. We could tell them, and they may be able to do something, but the problem is we don't know how powerful Shira is, which also plays into confront Shira. This is the problem, is I don't know, like, could we both take her? Could we both fight her? Because she does seem super duper strong, and if she's sucking the energy out of people, that means she, like, must, and she must have an immense power level. And she could probably kill Master, or Mage Warren and Master Mage Aramon, but they might... But what would happen? She would find out that we did it. And, like, if we tell somebody, they would have to confront her with us there, and she'd probably try killing us because we exposed her. And that sounds like it could turn... it sounds cliche enough that they would do something like, oh, you confronted her, the good guys and the bad guys are fighting. Oh, no, but she tries to make a pot shot at one of the students, and another, like, Charlie takes the hit for you and dies. Like... That sounds like a trope that this game would do, because this game is very tropey and very poorly written. So I would imagine it would do something that easily predictable. Okay, but so confronting Shira though, what's the option? I mean, if we confront Shira, then I guess we could probably. God, I don't know. If we confront Shira, then we could probably, like, surprise attack her? Like, both of us could, like, Eri could help us too, maybe. Like, we have a demon's advantage there. Because she could, like, help us out. Or maybe Eri could give us a tip on what kind of spell we can do to kill her. Or, like, incapacitate her or something. I don't know. God, it's such a tough choice. One of these is gonna fuck me entirely. But one of them... is the one, like, two of these choices could screw me completely, and one of them is going to be the right one. Based on the situation, based on everything that's happened, that's clearly always the bad choice. Clearly, that's never going to be the right choice. So it's down to these two. I really, in my heart, I feel like they would play the trope up. I'd feel like they'd play the trope up. I'm just going to say confront Shira.
Confront her?
We don't have to keep. We don't have to let her keep doing this to us.
And that's all? She's practicing some seriously messed up magic, Sophie.
Do you think anyone in the academy is going to believe that? She's one of them. They might even know about it themselves. What if Mage Warren does it to his students too? What if that's the whole system?
You're getting into some conspiracy theory nonsense, but...
Maybe I could be of some help?
Don't do that! My heart pounds against my chest, threatening to burst free. I thought we were done for. Aren't you supposed to be watching Shira?
Once she got her clothes on, I lost interest.
Is that what you call being helpful?
Well, fine. If you're so busy being rude, I guess you don't want to hear about her counterspell. Hear about the counterspell.
A counterspell?
A way to stop it, darling.
I know
what a counterspell is.
So I was right. Eri is going to help us out. Yeah. Demon magic.
I could teach it to you, but neither of you are as strong as she is. It would likely take the both of you to pull it off. And you'll get a nice little power boost, too.
That could be what we need to pass our trials.
How could you even think about that in a time like this? Really? Really? It's like you have your blinders on. Besides, it's what you need to pass. I can't take it yet.
She taps the side of her head, and my spirit falls a little. Oh, right.
If they let me sit in, I'll be the best cheerleader I can manage, but right now, we really need to focus on this Shira business.
We both have to be there to pull it off.
We can practice it after class, and then sleep together tonight.
Oh, invite me!
Not like that.
She frowns.
Then what's the point?
Are you going to class?
I can sit in and watch you, but I'm not doing anything hands-on for a few days. I just wanted to get out of the damn medical ward. I almost lost my mind in there.
I could have kept you company. All you needed to do was ask.
She gives me a look, but it's not quite the same soul-burning hatred I think it used to be. Instead, she just sighs.
Let's go to class.
It's ridiculous, looking at her and trying to see her as a dark magi. She has red hair for crying out loud. Would Shira really do something like that after everything she's done for me? I run through the drills with Shira again, who pushes me harder and harder every time. The spells and counterspells, even giving me advice as to what Mage Warren may try during our time together. I don't let my distractions bother me. Whatever Magi Shira might be, right now she's beneficial to me. Huh. Another ordinary day of learning magic. Magi Shira gives me a subtle smile at the end of our lesson, but doesn't break her strict attitude in public.
Good luck tomorrow, Sophie. I expect you'll do well. The same goes for you, Charlie, when you finally have your trial. I'll see you both tonight.
With a curt nod, she finally strides from the room, leaving me exhausted, my hands tingling from using such concentrated magic for so long.
You really did well, you know. Compared to when we first started, I don't think there's any way you'll lose.
Unless I never make it to the trial.
We can do this.
Maybe we should just wait until after?
Bad idea. She's taking our energy. You'd be even stronger if she didn't tamper with you the night before, and you know she will. You have to do something about it tonight.
Okay. Excuse me a second. I'm gonna go ahead and drink some water. Oh, God. Oh, my throat. Okay. Well, if we're gonna start learning some lessons, I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you like what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. As always, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst high school romance Magi Trials player you've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and
bye!